Okay, that's all installed. Let's check what else needs to be done. Right, these configs probably don't need changing, but that could have been overwritten, so let's have a look. So looking for something where locale char set has been set to true, looks of it. I shouldn't have done that, should I? Should have done that. So locale char set is true. And also looks like default editor should be set to vi. So let's look for that. And it is. And looks like persist cookie is true. System cookies, sorry, should be set to true as well. Yeah, that's set to true. So that's okay. And that's it. So that's Lynx installed. And I'll get rid of that tab. So we're back to the contents. Let's see what section it is. That'll be text-based browsers, if I can find it. There it is there. It's section chapter 18. I've got an R next to it to reload, rebuild. So that's been done. That can be crossed off as completed. So yeah, that's all done. Back to the contents. I'll put the same back here. So really the next thing to do is to start looking at the X windows, which will enable us to build the rest of the system much easily. So you can see it's quite a big set. In fact, there's a whole section just for building X windows and some display managers as well. There's a few libraries there. Display managers are used for logging in graphically, and then some window managers, which are like basic environments. So once we've got some form of graphical environment up, what I shall do after that, in fact, I think TWM is the, can't see, oh yeah, there it is there, yeah, TWM, a couple of applications there for it. Importantly, Xterm, so it'll be a terminal environment within the graphical environment. What I'll do next is concentrate on getting a graphical browser installed, and I'll probably choose, if I can find them, audio. Have I skipped past them? Yeah, I think I've skipped past them. Graphical web browsers, yeah, I'd probably go for Falcon. I think it's got fewer dependencies, as I remember. Although I do think that some of these dependencies have got other dependencies. I'd probably leave these and reinstall Fork and just get the required ones up and running. But yeah, basically, once we've got the Windows environment, things become a little bit easier because I can copy and paste a lot easier. I can have a terminal where I'm building on one side of the screen and another terminal with Lynx running. So I can still copy and paste from the text browser. But once I get the graphical browser going, then we'll really be going full steam ahead because it'll be so much easier to read on screen. And also the ease of copying and pasting will still be there as well. So yeah, that'll be the next thing to do in the next session, to start building the actual window interface, the GUI interface.